Welcome back to Circuit Showdown. What a surprising day we had yesterday. All three of our contestants are back.
We've decided not to send anyone home.
Oh boy.
So yesterday was pretty interesting.
Mm-hmm. It's pretty intense.
It was. And I think what was really interesting to me was that nobody's project ended up how they had originally intended for it to go.
Yeah, they all had to shift at some point, and they all had software issues at some point too. So it was really interesting to see how they dealt with it in order to complete their project.
Mm-hmm. Yep, everybody had to adjust, and I think yesterday's word of the day amongst the judges was resilience. So.
Yeah, and they showed some resilience.
Let's see what they've got going on today.
Round two.
But today is a new day and a new competition. Who will be the first Circuit Showdown champion?
But first, a big thank you to our sponsors, Arduino, Keysight, Molex, Renesas, and Vishay for helping to make this all possible.
So the contestants have all been given another shot to compete today.
What do you think they're gonna do different?
I don't know, let's go find out.
Hey guys.
Hey, Michael.
Good morning.
So what do you plan on doing differently today?
I'm hoping that on this time around, I'm trying to make it more polished by leaning more into the Arduino already built-in library.
Okay.
I feel like it will help me really streamline a lot of the issues that I was having yesterday when trying to implement some of the other parts that we were using on the Arduino board.
Okay.
That's one point. Good luck.
All right.
Thank you.
Hey, Renee.
Hi.
So what do you think you're going to do different today?
Today, I'm hoping to settle on what parts I'm using earlier. Yesterday, I had to shift partway through, and that kind of impeded my progress a bit. So I'm hoping that by choosing parts and just sticking with them, I'm going to be able to make more progress in the long run.
Do you think you're going to have the same issue with some of the libraries that you
I sure hope not.
Okay. Well, good luck today.
Thanks.
How are you doing today, Charles?
Hey, I'm alive, awake, alert.
All right, good. What do you plan on doing differently today?
So I'm gonna try to implement more functionality this time with more modules. Okay. My hope is to start with the simplest ones I feel most comfortable with, get as many of them as I can working early on. That way, later on, I can take risks with something that's possibly a bit more difficult to implement when I already have several functions completed.
Okay, so get the basics in first.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And now it's time to find out what you'll need to build today. Today's theme is industrial automation. Raymond, tell them what they'll need to build.
Hey, everybody. So for today's theme of industrial automation, think about the control systems normally found in advanced assembly and warehousing environments. Now remember, these systems are there to boost productivity, enhance quality, while maintaining the safety of the humans working in those environments. So contestants, today, using your Arduino Portenta C33 system on module, we are asking you to build a project that demonstrates the features of modern industrial automation.
And as a reminder, the criteria for your projects will be functionality, adherence to theme, usage of available resources, and originality.
And once again, you'll be starting with your Arduino Pro hardware, and the rest of your components will be located in the Mouser pop-up warehouse, where you'll have access to over hundreds of components and modules, including parts from Molex, Arduino, Renesas, and Vishay, as well as other items in the Mouser Innovation Lab.
Your time starts now. Good luck. Contestants, you only have 3 hours remaining.
What do you think they're building?
I was about to ask you that same question. Let's find out.
Hey, Michael.
Hey there,
Michael.
Guys. Didn't expect y'all so soon.
I know.
Well,
I know.
We're very anxious to find out what you're building today.
Today, what I'm going to try to do is what I'm calling the automated long-duration welder.
Okay.
ALD welder for short. And some of my experience with oil and gas, we have a lot of, and sometimes construction, we have projects that take very long beats of welds, mm-hmm. and that are usually just long consistent yep. lines that take maybe hours to days to keep passing. So I'm hoping to make a deployable system that you can basically magnetize to whatever material or state that you're working, and it'll consistently just do the passes that are required as numbered as it for wow. to reduce time and reduce labor.
Okay.
So
it's gonna be interesting. It's gonna have to withstand some heat too.
Oh
going
yeah.
On.
Yeah, for sure. So,
okay. Okay, Renee, what are you building today?
So I'm kind of taking a going for an area of industry that's kind of like close to my heart, which is like agriculture. I'm from a farming town, so I was interested in creating a remote beehive monitoring system for
okay.
beekeepers.
Very cool.
Right now I'm working on temperature, loudness, and vibration sensors, so you can kind of monitor what's going on in the hive and the conditions.
Okay.
So the beekeepers don't actually have to go out in like 100 degree temperatures.
All right,
awesome.
Great.
Good luck.
Hey, Charles.
Hey.
All right, we're excited to find out what you're working on today.
He's coding right now.
Yeah. Oh, well, so I'm trying to make something, like, it's really hot out here. You probably didn't notice, but
it's
kind of toasty sometimes. So industrial workers still have to work in that. So yeah. I'm trying to make something that monitors, essentially, if they're getting too hot, well, in terms of the temperature, in terms of they're starting to sweat, then activate some motors. Should have little fans on them to try to cool them down.
Oh, okay.
As well as just display some basic information. And if I get time, try to also track other information that maybe steps or how far or fast they're traveling.
Okay.
So that's what I'm trying to work on.
Now, I saw you grab those micro DC motors, right? Is this going to be like some sort of wearable?
That was the idea. Like, well, okay. My particular idea was like for like your pant legs or whatever, something that clips on with there, a little motor, and then it can measure your like body temperature as well as like if you're starting to sweat because you've been out in the heat all day.
All right, we'll let you get back to work.
Precision is critical when debugging a design. The brand new Keysight InfiniVision HD3 series is a 14-bit analog-to-digital converter oscilloscope, delivering 4 times the signal resolution and half the injected noise of other general-purpose oscilloscopes, allowing you to capture the smallest, most elusive signals. A new user interface features a split display. Utilize the full ADC and vertical resolution for every channel, and even set custom measurement thresholds. With custom hardware, the industry's only fault hunter software, deep memory architecture, and the world's only uncompromised 1.3 million waveforms per second update rate, Keysight HD3 series oscilloscopes are the ideal tool for debugging, interference hunting, and sub-millivolt signal analysis.
So the wearable that you're doing, is that supposed to like also just work like as a personal fan setup, or is that like
sort of? That's the idea. Oh, no. That what I have is like, so one function is to be automated, the other is also like a manual turn on off if you want, but then also like be able to send back some amount of data.
So you're just like mounting all the fans like just in tandem, like on a headband, or is it like on a necklace?
Like I was thinking more like what's called. Either something that clips on your belt or goes up your shirt, or something that clips on your pant leg.
Oh, that's actually pretty cool. Mm-hmm. I actually would like that.
So Michael's actually making a sort of like an inspection system for welding that's actually going to be able to run along the bead line and check out the welds, which is actually pretty cool. Mm-hmm. I mean, I could see that being really useful in that industry. Mm-hmm.
Renee is working on an...
So she's basically, it's a monitor inside the beehive.
Inside the beehive.
So I guess it's bee farming? Is it bee farming?
Beekeeping.
Right, beekeeping.
Yeah, yeah.
So they don't have to always go out and check on the bees. So
especially
they could do
if
it remotely. Right. So
yeah.
which is pretty cool. Yeah. Charles was actually building a wearable that detects your body temperature and helps you cool down. So he explained it as like the automated version of doing this when you're hot, mm-hmm. right?
but for use in a manufacturing environment?
He's talking about the workers who
work
still
outside.
Have to work outside in the heat. And
I
so
see.
To keep
I
them
see.
Cool and monitor their mm-hmm. temperature.
So what do you think they're gonna have to do with some of these designs in order to really get them going?
Well, I think clearly the industrial automation as an overall concept is so vastly different than the previous projects that have more of a consumer in-home application. requires an entirely different way of thinking. And I'm curious to see how or whether or the degree to which they utilize sensors or potentially robotics.
What about you, Kirk? What are you thinking?
Yeah, I think based on the amount of time I've spent in industrial situations, I think that either scalability or portability of, of designs.
Massimo, what's your thoughts?
Well, I think all three projects have challenges in there, so it'll be interesting to see how they kind of, you know, actually implement the ideas. And I'm pretty sure maybe a couple of these ideas might evolve during the 4 hours.
Should we use that yesterday.
Yes, very much so. And most things we use today at some point were just something cool that someone thought of.
Right.
So I like that they're thinking of cool things, you know.
All right, let's go see what Charles is up to.
All right, let's do it.
All right, Charles, we won't take up too much of your time, but we want to see what you're up to.
So I've got now a little OLED that's going to display information when I get there. I've implemented the water and temperature sensor already, trying to fine tune them to get them more accurate. But eventually it should display information on there. And then right now I'm trying to convert, instead of using the power supply to supply power for my motors, I'm going to try to supply it from the board. I need like 3.3 volts, and I'm trying to just reduce that down to the proper amount.
What's the title of your overall design?
I'm calling it industrial worker cooldown. So it's collecting information on, you know, if they're getting hot, overheated, then automatically turning fans on just to try to cool them down. And then, if time permitting, we'll also try to, you know, collect other information such as distance traveled or number of steps taken. Especially, I'm thinking like people who work in warehouses or work out in, like, you know, construction kind of thing.
Nice concept.
Is everything going according to your initial plan so far?
It's going okay in terms of getting some functionality, just fine-tuning it and then making them all work together. That's the main question.
All right. So
I was just going to ask about your use of sensors.
So I have just the, right now I only have the temperature and moisture sensor. So the moisture, the idea is when someone's beginning to sweat, they probably could use a fan cooling them down.
Right.
So that's the idea there.
Well, he's into it. Best of luck. I don't want to get in your way.
Thank you.
Thanks, Charles. FIRST, founded by Dean Kamen in 1989, has reached over 3.2 million youth participants in over 100 countries, preparing the next generation with advanced STEM education.
Hey, Renee.
Hi.
How's it going today?
Pretty well. I managed to get three sensors working. So I got temperature, humidity, and loudness. And since I kind of figured out that the vibration sensor either it would just tell me, is it vibrating or is it not vibrating? And since bees will be making noise if they're there, the loudness, because it gives like an actual like numerical reading, is more helpful than vibration on its own. So I decided to just go with loudness.
Okay. Yeah, and I'm intrigued by your whole project. Is coming from bees. Is this more of a trying to keep them safe in the summer from overheating? Does it also help like in the winter? I know if a hive gets too cold, the bees can freeze, those kind of things.
Yeah, it definitely could help with both. The main goal that I have for it is just to decrease the labor required from the beekeepers, because if they have sensors in the hives, they can tell if they're okay based on like the noise readings in the hive and the temperature and humidity, so they won't have to go out and manually check hives, because oftentimes they're miles away from each other, and that just takes up a lot of their time.
Okay, no, it's very interesting, and I'm always intrigued by agriculture products. You know, I come from a agriculture background in my family also, so I really like that, and you know, again, don't want to take up too much of your time, but glad to see things seem to be going a little better.
Yeah.
Three of the sensors going.
Glad to. Yes.
Yeah. So good. Awesome. And good luck with the whole project.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Renee. Good luck.
Hello.
Hey there, guys.
What's happening?
So right now, I'm making a lot more progress than I did yesterday. I'm getting the servos to work. Right now, they're conflicting commands, but I'm going through that in through my code right now. But so far, it's going well. I'm basically trying to make an automated welder. This electromagnet would hold on to metal pieces. This would act as my rolling servo that would go along a track on either like a plane surface, and then this would actually act as the welder itself, basically providing a bead by doing a weighting motion over the material. The provided sensors will just kind of keep it in line, so this would be my line sensor that would keep it along the track. Mm-hmm. This would be the thermal imaging camera, because you obviously can't look at an arc because of the UV rays, and then this would be the temperature and humidity sensor to make sure that the weld is going to be completed within spec.
So at the moment, do you plan to make something that actually moves the piece, or are you going to see
Yes, it? Yeah. So I was originally was going to use the conveyor belt that we have provided, but then I had issues with trying to get the right voltage that I would want for it. Mm. So right now, I'm just going to stick with this. That's why I'm hoping to maybe make this into like a gear, or maybe attach it to a piece of cardboard to like allow it to kind of run on a track.
So if you're using multiple servo motors, check two things. The power supply might not be enough for both of them to work at the same time.
Yeah.
And second, check because not all the pins on the microcontroller might be able to support servo motors.
Yeah, for sure. So that's what I'm going through right now.
Okay.
All right, and I'm sure we can stay here and talk all day, but I am going to pull Massimo away and get you back to work.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Contestants, you have only 2 hours remaining.
Shout out to Arduino for helpful error codes.
I know, it's actually really nice, because then it's like, oh.
Instead of just being like, sorry, it didn't work. It's like, it didn't work. Try resetting the board.
Well, that, I appreciate really that. Also, the line number listed, like when you had errors.
Here's a design tip from Molex. Always consider both the expected and unexpected environments that your final product will see over its life cycle. Any device can end up outside, and a careless moment by the end user could result in water damage to the electrical circuits. Even household appliances like washing machines and ice makers are susceptible to broken hoses, so it's important to ensure that an occasional rainstorm or broken water line will not damage your electrical circuits of your product. For household electronics and portable electronics, rugged and reliable automotive-grade connectors provide excellent protection from moisture and debris in worst-case scenarios.
All right, contestants, can you pause for just a moment? As we all know, engineering projects don't always go as planned. There are often changes to specifications and requirements midstream. We learned a little bit about that yesterday. But since you guys are doing so well now, we thought we'd shake it up a little bit. So we are calling in our chief mentor, Raymond, to tell us how we're gonna do that.
All right, everyone. So is everybody familiar with the Internet of Things? Okay, so the industrial Internet of Things is transforming the industry by making real-time data available for analysis. And so what you're asking you to do now to add to your project is to create an Internet of Things dashboard using the Arduino IoT cloud to be able to display data from your hardware and make them visible to the judges upon demonstration.